Hello, my name is Jan Thielemann, and in this video I want to talk about models, documents, custom accounting and workflows. And yeah, I have this wiki page called Models, Documents and Custom Accounting. It's located in the plugin development section of the IdemPierre wiki, which you can find under wiki.idempierre.org/yen/category/plugin development. And yeah, today I want to go through this tutorial step by step and yeah, show you how to implement a custom document type. So what I want to do here is I have a example where a dictator wants to use IdemPierre to create battle plans and keep track of his expenses and so on. And the goal is that generals are able to create battle plans, then they can complete this document. But another group or role, the commanders, have to add war machines, attach war machines to this battle plan. And then finally, the mighty leader has to approve this document. And yeah, the thing is, a general can create a battle plan, completes the document, then the commander has to do something with it, and then the supervisor has to approve this battle plan. And to achieve this, we need different things. We need some database tables, we need model classes, and we need a document class. And maybe the most important thing is that we need a workflow. So what is a document in IdemPierre? Yeah, a document is just like a real document. For example, an invoice. One person in your company writes the invoice, another person has to approve it, or a purchase order. If you want to buy something in a bigger company, then it might be the case that if the thing you buy, if it costs more than a given value, some higher instance has to approve this purchase order. And yeah, that's what you can use documents and workflows for. So let's start with this tutorial. Here's again the statement of the problem. So it describes that there's the mighty leader who wants to create the battle plans, or let the battle plans created by the generals. And yeah, here we already have some database tables I made earlier. And the first thing I need to do is to import them in my database. So I open an SQL shell and just run this scripts. I have the battle plan itself. Then I have battle plan lines where you can attach the war machinery. Then I have a battalion just for the lulz, and the war machines I can attach to the battle plans. So okay, these should now be in my database. The next step I have to do is to create the tables, columns, windows, and so on. And to do this, I go to my IdemPierre server, log in a super user on the system client with the system administrator role, open table and columns window, and start importing my tables I just created. I use ROK as my table prefix. If you make custom tables, you should always use three letters as the prefix. And when you create a table in IdemPierre, you should write this in uppercase, because later when we generate the models, it will use exactly the same name entered here. So following conventions for camel case and the IdemPierre conventions where the prefix is written in uppercase letters, I can now create my tables in item here. So the first was battle. Oh no, let's start with the battalion. I just use the same name here. And I set the data access level to everybody. Normally, I think you could use client and organization or organization level only. But yeah, for my case, I test a lot, and so therefore I use all. Then I can test this window on system client as well as on the other clients. Next step is to create the columns from the database. And yeah, there they are. So do I have to change something for this? No, I don't believe so. But for other tables, okay. Next table was war machine, I guess. Yes, war machine. Here the same again. Create a columns really quick. Okay. Now the battle plan table. Okay. And finally, the battle plan line. Okay. Create the columns. Nice. So, now the battle plan table is the table which I want to use for my document, my custom document. And if you take a look at the SQL statement, I made some comments. We have the 9 default columns every item peer table must have. Then I have some document columns, which indicate that this table is a document and you must have these columns. Otherwise, your table item peer won't accept your table as a document. And because I also want custom accounting, we need these columns here. And finally, my user columns I use to enter my data. Okay. And when I create the columns in item Pierre, item Pierre uses some default values to generate these columns. And since I want a custom document, I have to change it a little bit. If you are not sure how to, then or to what you have to change it, then you can also take a look at other document tables like the cOrder table or cInvoice table and take a look at their columns. Here, for my case, I already wrote down what I have to change. So I choose my battle plan, and the first thing I have to do is make cdoc type ID not updatable and set a default logic to 0. So I search for cdoc type ID, make it not updatable, and the default logic is 0. Okay, then the next column, which is cdoc type target ID. Here I have to set the reference to table instead of table direct. And the reference key is cDocType. Save this one. Now I need a dynamic validation because the column is now configured to display every different doc type. But I want only to be able to use one doc type. I don't want to use sales order or standard order in my table. That wouldn't make sense. So I go to the dynamic validation window. And here I create a new validation and I call it doc type proc. It's a SQL type. And I will just copy the SQL from here. And save it. Then I can use it here. Doc type rogue. And all this does, there's a video about dynamic validation on this channel. And what it does is it takes a look at, we have a table reference here, which references the CDoc type. If I zoom in here, you can see that this is a table validation and the table is CDoc type. And here I filter this table based on the doc base type column. And this has to be ROK. And then IdemPierre will only provide me this one entry in my dropdown list. Okay, the next step is the document number. So I search the document number, and this is not updatable and should also be part of the identifier. Next thing, the doc action. I have to change the reference type to button so that it can call a process. The reference key is document action. And I also need a process which is started. And this process will be our workflow. So I first go to the report on process window, set my data access level. And since my table is accessible from everywhere, the process should also be accessible from everywhere. I call this process battle plan and save it. I don't have a workflow yet, but IdemPierre doesn't care about this. I can attach the process anyway and save it. Okay. Oh yeah, the default logic should be CO, which stands for complete. And when I hit the button and complete the document, it will provide me with complete as the default document action. So the next thing is doc status. Yeah, I have to change the reference key. Save this one. And the default logic is drafted. So when I create a new entry or a new document, then it gets the drafted status by default. Next, I need the processed. The processed on. Yeah, this one. And this is not updatable. Okay. Now the processed. I made a mistake. I should have made processed not updatable. Okay. And processed on is updatable, but set the length to 20. As you see, by default, IdemPierre has set the length to a much higher value than we need. And now the processing button. And here I use the same process, which I also used for my doc action. So change it to button. And this is process battle plan. And save it. Next column is approved, which is by default no, I guess. I copied this from the sales order window. Now the date act, which is the date when the document was accounted. I only need the date here, save it. The length of the date should be 7. Save this one. And I should have some default logic, but it's apparently missing in the wiki. So what I can do here is just go to the C order window, go to columns, search for the date act column, and okay, this is the default logic. I'll fix this in the wiki after I recorded this video. Okay, save it, and the next column is the post-it button. Whoops. The post-it button will appear when the document is completed and the counting entries were created. And if you click on it, it will lead you to a window where you can see the accounting entries which were created. Okay, so it's a button. And the reference key is postage status. The default logic is no, it's not posted. And finally, the currency column, where I will just use the default currency from the system, and it shouldn't be updatable. And last but not least, I have to change something on the battle plan line. Here I use the current battle plan as the default for the battle plan ID. I do this so IdemPierre can link the subtab to the parent tab. It's not updatable, and it's the parent link column. Okay, save this one. I believe that's it for the tables and columns. If not, we will see later when something doesn't work. Now I have to create windows for all my new tables, and I will call them just like the tables, which was war machine. Okay. Create a new tab with this table. Save this one. And create the fields. Wonderful. Next window is the battalion. Yeah, I also only need to create one tab with this table and create my fields. I don't have to change much here. But now it gets more interesting when I create the battle plan window, which has two tabs. First tab is the battle plan, the parent tab. Save this one. Create the fields. Thank you. That were all fields. I think something went wrong here. Something went really wrong here. I used the wrong table here. So I just changed this to line. Save it. This is tab level 1. And sequence 20. Save it, create new entry. And this time I want the battle plan, not the battle plan line. Yeah, that's better. Tab level 1. And it is sequence number 10. So the first tab in the window is the battle plan. The second tab on tab level 1 is the battle plan line. Okay, nice. Create the fields. That looks better. And now I have to make some changes here. I want to hide the accounting date. Let me drag this a little bit bigger. Which columns don't we need? The accounting date. We don't need this column. The approved column. The process now button. We don't need this. The process, we don't need it. Processed on is not needed. And save this one. Where can I make it shorter again? Yeah, okay. Now I go to the fields and set the display logic of the posted button so that it only appears if the entry was processed and if the system is configured to show accounting tabs. Save this one. The currency should be read-only. Wrong button. The document type here is also read-only, so I cannot change it. And the same goes for the document status. And save it. Okay, next is to create menu entries for my stuff. So I have the battle plan window, which is a window. Then I have the war machines. And the battalion. And save it. Now I can log out and log back in again to see the menu entries or just change the role. And there they are. I have a battalion. Yeah, this seems to work. I have my war machines. And I also have my battle plans. And you can see that I can enter stuff here. I have no target document type yet because we haven't created a custom document type. But the window is there and it seems to work. So the next step, according to the wiki page, is to create a custom document type in the application dictionary. And to do this, we first need to open the reference window and search for the C doc type reference, the document base types, which is a list validation in the format of three letters. So I go to the list validation tab and here I make a new entry, call it ROK, just like I called it here in my dynamic validation. This has to be the same, otherwise IDMPR will not find your document type. And this is a ROK battle plan. Okay, then we can close this window. And now I can create a new document type. But since I want to use accounting, it's a good idea to create a document type on the system where you we'll use it later, because if you create a document type on a system client, then you may not find it on the other client. So I Open the document type window on Gardenwood. And here I create a new document. I call it battle plan. The category is none. And here I use the Rokian battle plan. Okay, nice. So when I open the window here, oops, this was the wrong window, battle plan window here, you can see it finds my battle plan. This should be read only. Maybe I forgot to set this, but we will fix it in a second. Oh no, okay, it's just not updatable. I wonder if the document number in the sales order is, oh yeah, okay. Nice. Then I didn't make a mistake. So okay, here we have a new document entry, and now we can use the document action to do different stuff with this document. For example, complete it. And when I hit the button, you see an error. And this is because we haven't implemented a workflow for this document yet. And think about a workflow as the necessary steps a document needs to go through to transition into another state. The document, when it is new, it has the state drafted. And then I can, for example, say, okay, I filled out every field in my document, and now I want to complete it so that some accounting information is posted, or some, I don't know how to describe it. I'm sorry, but for example, I complete the document, and if it costs more than a given value, then my supervisor has to approve it, and then it is completed and the posting is done. So the next step is to create the workflow. But before we do this, when we follow this tutorial, you see the next step is the model and the document factory, and then create some other stuff. So we will strictly follow this wiki tutorial and create document and model factories. And what they are for. Yeah, you see this document is basically a normal table. And if you watched the other videos in this channel, then you might know that every window in IdemPierre is backed by a model class. IdemPierre provides default models for my table for now, because I haven't implemented custom models yet. And this is the next step I do. The model class for my table will also serve as a document model. And I need another class, which begins with doc underscore. And this is the document class, which is used for accounting. When I make custom accounting entries, then it is done by this class. Okay, so open Eclipse. Here it is. I can stop my server for now and create a new plugin. So I go to the plugin development, choose plugin project, hit next. I don't want my plugins in my IdemPierre repository, because if I would commit them, I would always have to share my whole IdemPierre with all my plugins. And if I just use a custom path to store my plugins, then I can only share these plugins. So create a new directory here, and I call this Kong-Jim battle plan. Okay. So Eclipse will store my code in this plugin. I also used the this as the name. I use the Equinox OSGI framework, because IdemPierre uses Equinox. Execution environment. Normally I change it to 1.6 because IdemPR is also compiled with 1.6. And finish this. If you hit the properties on the base and go to the Java compiler, you see that IdemPR uses 1.6. Okay, so here's my plugin. And what I have to do now is to create some classes here. I don't need an activator. I don't know why I didn't check this, but okay. So here I create a new package for my model classes and one package for my document classes. Here I have to create different classes. The first class is my document factory. This will be a Node.js factory, which provides my custom document class to IdemPR. Also, I need my doc rock battle plan, which is the implementation of my doc. And I also need model classes, but I don't want to write them by my own. So I go to run configurations in the Eclipse application and start the model generator. Here I choose my my plugin source folder, and the package is uncongim. And I want all tables which start with ROK and have the entity type user maintained, generated, and you see my four models were generated. Now I need, refresh this one. I forgot the model. Okay, so I will just delete this one and refactor this one. Here I can open it, and I also need an M class, at least for my battle plan. It's not really necessary to provide all the other model classes from my plugin, because it will work pretty well with the default model provided by IdemPR. But for my battle plan, I really need a model class because I implement something in there. So the first thing I do here is extend the X class, which is XROK battle plan. Add my constructors. Wait, what's wrong here? The hierarchy is inconsistent. Okay, that's interesting. Maybe because I haven't imported the or set the dependencies correctly. So I go to my manifest, open the dependencies tab, and I have to add the base plugin here. And hey, the error is gone. Add my serial ID. And I want to implement two different interfaces. The first one is doc action. Which provides me all this document actions IdemPR can have. For example, when you prepare a document, the prepared method gets called. If you complete it, the completed method gets called. And also, I want to show you something really nice. As you saw maybe before, here when I hit, I stopped the server. Okay, when I hit the document action button. It provided me with two options. The first one was completed, the second one was voided. If I want other actions to be visible, I can implement the doc options, which gives me this nice method, customize valid actions. And what you can do here is, take a look at here real quick. I copy the code from here because I'm lazy. So, yeah, the first thing I do is to check the options, and if they are null, or if the doc action is null, then yeah, something went terribly wrong. Fix the imports, okay. And here, what I do is I check if my doc status is drafted or invalid, and if it is so, I not only provide complete and void, but I also provide prepare. And when the document is completed, normally all you have is to close this document, but I also want to void it or reactivate it, so I provide this here. Yeah, that's really simple. And for other examples, you can take a look at the document engine, I guess. We can check this out by searching where this method is referenced. But it seems that it is not referenced here, so I go another way, go to the doc options, and check out what they are used. But it's also not what I'm searching for. I believe it's in document engine, maybe. Get valid actions. Yeah. Here you see the default behavior of item peer. So by default, if your status is drafted or invalid, you only get complete and voided. And if you wonder why you have other actions in the sales order, if you scroll down here, you see that every default item peer document has its own implementation of the doc status available. That's not really nice, but it was though in item peer, and I believe in comp peer too. And now that we move to OSGI in item peer, we can do this nicely here in our custom model and provide all the stuff we are OSGI in our plugin without changing any of the default code of item peer. Okay, I have to do other stuff here. So in my processed method, which is this one, I paste this code. I want to lock everything which is called, so I add a lock here. And when my document gets processed, I get the document engine and let the engine process my document. Okay. So the next steps is in the prepared method. And when your document is prepared and you return null, then it won't get prepared. So you always have to make sure that, yeah, when your business logic is done and everything was successful, you have to return the document status, which I do here. Also, when my document gets prepared, I want that my C doc type ID is set to the target document type. The target document type is the document type I can choose by myself. And the C doc type is not updatable and read only. So what you could do here is you could prepare your document, and depending on the values you entered, you could choose a different document type. But I don't need this here, so I only do this, and I want to lock all my methods. So I just add here lock warnings. You don't have to do this, but yeah, I do it. I also return a true in every method. Normally, you would implement some business logic which would check if voiding was possible, which deletes the accounting entries and so on, but I don't need all this. I just return true everywhere. I could copy this. That's much faster. Let's return null here. I don't think we need this. Wait, what have I done? The wrong button. Okay. Returning null everywhere. Here I return big decimal zero, but if I when I return null in this method and somebody wants to use this big decimal, he would get a null pointer exception. I don't want this. And add the locks, of course. And complete it. I also need to return a doc action, which is, oops, doc action complete. And because I did it up there, I do it here also. Oh, wait, I have to return the status completed. Yes, that's right. Since I implement the doc action, I could access this variables directly, but who cares? Okay, here logging returning true. Copy this code. Feel free to skip the video till I'm done with all this, which is the case now. Then I create a model factory. Here I implement the iModelFactory interface and its methods. Then I check if the table name, which the document factory provides me, equals to my M classes table name. Then I return this class. Okay, copy this code here. Here I return a new instance. And down here, the same, but with a result set. Also, I want loggings here, so I again copy this code and place it in here. Save it. I don't have a logger in my model factory. Okay. Then I'll do it this way. Now I can close this one. Normally you would add model classes for all your other models, but as I described before, I don't need this since I only want my document. Then I have to create component definitions. One for the model factory. And one for the document factory. Here they are. In my document factory, I have to implement the iDocFactory interface at the unimplemented methods. And yes, I don't have the code ready for this one. That's not good. So I will have to search it by myself. Take a look at the default document factory and copy the code from here. And then I also have to copy the logger. Okay. And this method also. Copy this one. Place it in here. I don't need this, I don't need this. I don't need all this. And now I simply check if the table name equals my battle plans table name. Then I return a new instance. Of my battle plan document. Now I need the code for my document, which I copied from the wiki. Fix my imports. And something's not right here. Oops, no. It should be this one. What I'm doing wrong? Ah, okay, I have to extend the doc class and import it, of course. Okay, so that's better. Yeah, what I do here is I extend the base document class and implement the three methods here. My fact acts are simply empty list. Here again, I return big.0 because if idempr wants to access this variable I return and it is null, then it would throw a null pointer exception. And here I return an empty string or null. It also works with null. I can close the document, but first I want to add logs so I can see what happens on my console. Save this one and I can close it. So here I have to provide AS, RS, and what was the last thing? And the transaction name. Okay. Yeah, so this will do it. That's my document factory, my document. And now I can implement my component definitions. Here I have to provide a unique name, which is unique across the whole the whole application. So what I like to do is to use my plugin's name followed by what it is. So in this case it would be Un Kong Jim Battle Plan Document Factory. The class which it implements is my document factory. Save this one. And here I have to add some properties. The first is the service ranking property, which is an integer and has a value of 100. And what this does is when idempr asks the OSGI framework about all the document factories, it returns a list which is ordered by the service ranking. And the default document factory from idempr is the last in the list if you put a service ranking property in your plugin, and you should always do this. Another property we need is the gap, which I set to star. And the thing here is that item pair will ask your document factory for which accounting types it is, and if I use gap, it will be used every time, no matter what your accounting it is. If it is German or American or Korean or Rockian, it will use my document. So save this, go to the services tab and add the iDocument, the iDocFactory interface. Take a look at the source code and check if everything is okay here. Yes, it is. Then I can go to my model factory. Same here, I have to provide a unique name, add my class, add the service ranking property, which is an integer, value 100 or 1000 or whatever you like. Then add the I model factory interface here. Check if the code is okay. Because I found that sometimes Eclipse messes up my my component definitions and put this part right here somewhere down here, and then I have to fix it manually, but this one looks fine. Now I check my manifest to see if my component definitions are here. Yes, my two service components are here. That's nice. So yeah, I believe that that is all I have to do in code for now. Now I can start my server again. Go to run configurations, server, plugins. Check my plugin and set it auto start to true. And run the server. Oops, I got some problems over here. Oh, I forgot to remove my bundle activator, which I do now. Real quick, stop this and start it again. This looks better. Yeah, and as you see, my model factory gets loaded, the persistent objects get loaded. If I go to the battle plan window, then my model should get loaded. If I do some document action, I get the error again, because I don't have a workflow yet. So that's the next thing to do, implement a workflow for my document. But before I can do this, I have to add some users and roles and so on to the garden world, so it will be clear to you. And yeah, I have to add three users and two roles. So I do this real quick, go to the user window here and add a new user. Jim, who is the mighty leader of our country. Okay, his password is also just Jim. Save it. And of course, he has to be attached to a business partner so he can log in. In this case, because it's the mighty leader, I use the garden admin business partner. Then I have General A. Garden user and Commander A. Who's also the garden user business partner. Okay, now I can go to my role window and create a new role. I call this role Commanders. And another one, I call it generals. Let's save this one. Then, because I'm lazy, I copy my role settings from guard user to commanders and to the generals. Okay. Seems that it worked. And then I have to assign my users to these roles. Orc access is all orcs. The users here are Commander A and Big Jim is also in there. Then I go to the generals. There they are. Same here. Add organizations. Go to the user assignments and add the commander and Jim. And I believe that's all for the users and roles. Now we can start creating our workflow, finally. So log into a system client. And, oh, I forgot something on the Garden World client. Haha. Before we can create a workflow, I would like to, I don't want to be signed in as the commander, but as the admin, so that I get my windows. So here in the workflow responsible window, you can define different kinds of persons or groups who are responsible for a workflow. That means, for example, if I only want Jim Kong Un to approve battle plans, then I have to make a new entry here. I call it Jim in my case. Jim is a human and the user is Jim. Save this one. Then my generals can create these battle plans and my commanders have to attach war machines. So I create commanders. Commanders in this case is a role. And here I use the commander's role. The same goes for the generals. And this is also a role. The general's role. Save this one. Okay. Now I can go to the system client again. Here I open the report and process window and search my my process I just made. Click on the workflow and I create a new workflow. And I call it process battle plan. The data access level is all. And the workflow type is document process because I want to process a document. The author is of course myself. Save this one. The table is the battle plan table. Save this one. Open the table and columns. And here on my battle plan, I now can select the battle plan window so that it can be found in zooming records or so. What else do I have to do? Everybody can access it. I have to choose a starting node, but we don't have any nodes yet. And the notes are the different steps which have to be done so that the document transitions into other states. So I'm on system and my workflow responsibles are on the garden world. So I will create a part of the notes on my system client and the other part on the garden world client. And there are some default notes the most workflows have, which are start, prepare, complete, and auto. And the approve and war machine, as you see, I will create them on Garden World. Okay, so let's create these nodes real quick. Start node is the This is wait sleep, I guess. Yes, that's right. Okay. I can just save this. Then I create the prepare node, which is document action, the prepare action, of course. Save this one. Then the doc complete node, which is also a document action. Complete, save this. And last but not least, I have the doc auto, which is a document action too, but none. And save this one. Okay, now I can go back to the garden world. The admin role. Okay. Open the workflow. Search for my process battle plan. Go to the notes tab and add the missing two notes here, which is doc approve. And I do this on this client because I want only Jim to approve these documents. So he is the workflow responsible for this node. Only he can do this node. And here I use a user choice because Jim decides whether or not the document is approved, and the column is approved. And if you make user choices on other columns, they differ a little bit from the is approved column. The is approved column is treated a little bit different. This is hard coded, and yeah, it's a little bit different to other user choices you may do. Okay, the last node I have to create is the Add War Machines node, which is also a user action, but this time I use user window, and here I use the Rock Battle Plan window. So this indicates that the user has to open the window, enter some information, close it, and hit the button so that the transition is made. Talking about transitions, I now have to make them. I use the workflow editor for this, and here I choose my process battle plan workflow. And from the start node, I add lines to prepare and to auto. From prepare, I go to add war machines. From war machines, I go to approve. And from approve, I go to complete. So the basic workflow here is the general enters information in the battle plan, then he clicks on complete it. The workflow goes to prepare and prepares the document, then goes automatically to add war machines. There it stops, and then the commander sees that he has a new workflow activity waiting for him. After he's finished with this, the transition goes to doc approve, and then Jim has the workflow activity to approve this. And if he decides, yes, I approve this document, then the document is completed and accounting entries are created. Okay, so now I have to zoom into this node, but I cannot do it, unfortunately. But I'm still here. So go to the start node in the transitions tab. And you see here the workflow editor used the same sequence number for both of my actions, but I want this action to have the line number 100. Okay, save it. Yeah, now basically I think we're ready for testing. So go to the battle plan window. But first I log out here, and here I use the general A. Wrong password. Oh, that's not good. I made a mistake somewhere. No, I didn't. What's wrong? Invalid user ID or password. Huh? What's with Jim? Jim can log in? Okay, I have to check this. So I go back to the user window. General A. Why doesn't he have a user role? Oh, maybe I forgot to save it. Okay, log out. Ah, now it works. And I can open the battle plan window. And yeah, enter some information here. And then when the information is entered, I hit the document action complete. Haven't I attached the process yet? This is life, ladies and gentlemen. Changing the role to system, okay. Report and process, battle plan. And I forgot to attach the workflow, of course, to the process. Yep. So attach the workflow to the process. Log out again. Log in with the general. And now I should be able to complete this document. And it gets terminated. Why does it get terminated? I don't get it. Okay, let's create another entry here. And hopefully it will work this time. Save it. As you see, my model factory is going crazy on my console. Okay. What does this error mean? Ah, okay. I know what's wrong. I forgot to set the starting node of the workflow. Go back to super user system and log in on the system client. Open the workflow again. And choose start as the start node. Save it. And this time it should work, hopefully. So go to the battle plan window, complete the document. And as you see, the status just has changed to in progress because it was prepared. And there we, in the, prepare method of our model, which is this one. We return the in progress status. And then the workflow automatically goes to the next node, which is at War Machine. And yeah, I'm the general and I can hit this button again, but it says that the workflow is suspended on the node at War Machine and the user is super user. Because I believe I forgot to change the responsibles for this. So again, log out to super user system, but I want the administrator role, just this one. Open the workflow. And now you already know what this workflow responsible is for. It automatically uses the supervisor of Nothing Center, which is the super user. So the responsible for adding the war machines should be the commanders. Thank you. Jim is the only one who's allowed to approve. And yeah, maybe you could set the commanders to start this workflow, so only commanders could start it. But I don't care about this yet. So yeah, currently you see the workflow is for me, and this is the user window node type. You have to click on this window, then enter some information here, like this, save it, close it, and when you're done, you hit the OK button, and the node is gone. So if I now take a look back at this entry right here and click on the action, you see that the workflow is now on the node doc approve and only Jim can approve it. So I log out and use Jim's user. Oh, I forgot to add Jim to the garden admin role, but that doesn't matter yet. So here I see I have this node in my workflow activities, and here since it's a user choice on is approve, and is approve is a yes no field, I have yes and no. So I click on yes, hit the action, the OK button, and if I take a look at my document here, you see it is completed. And now if I take a look here at my console, you see that you see two things. The first thing is that my model gets called. And the second thing you should see, but you don't see it, I guess, is that the document factory returns my document class, but it doesn't. And why is this the case? Let me check this. Let me debug my code. So first I will remove the lock from the model factory because this is annoying. Gets called too often. Now I can debug my server. And see why my factory isn't loaded. Who am I? I'm Jim, okay. Since Jim is in all the roles, he can do everything by himself. I mean, hey, he's the mighty leader. Why shouldn't he? So I'll save this one, complete it. Just hit the OK button. And the document was completed. Not found. Rock Battle Plan ID. And I believe I know what the error is. Let me just check one thing. Remove these. Okay. So, what do I do here? And why does it not work like I would have expected it? Not found. Battle plan ID was some number, okay. Why is this the case? So I have my document factory, but it seems that it is not loaded correctly. Is this true? Because I'm debugging, but nothing happened. Yeah, I give it another try. This time I will just reactivate it and to me, it seems that it uses the wrong document factory because my own document factory is never loaded. So why is this the case? Why is this the case? I'll put breakpoints here. So I just reactivated the document and now I want to complete it again. Clear my lock. Okay. Hit okay. And doesn't work. What's wrong with you, my friend? Doc Manager Post Document. So is it this one or this one? I'll just add breakpoints to both of them. Okay, here we are. So, my table name is null. Yes, that's okay. Let's go over this one. Yeah, the table name seems to be correct. Ah, okay. I think because we don't process the document on completed. Yes. Okay, that's my mistake. If I would have followed the tutorial, then I wouldn't have had this problem. The thing is that only processed documents get posted. So I have to set the processed flag to true in the completed method, just like I did in my wiki entry here. And now, finally, it should work. So I clear my lock again, reactivate my document. Go to my workflow activities and okay. And it still doesn't get completed. But why? I don't get it. Okay, so I'll debug this real quick and put a cut in here because otherwise the video will get even longer. And I see you in a second. Yeah, I'm back, and by now you are probably laughing very hard because I made some changes to the source code and didn't restart my server. Then, of course, it does not work. But now I restarted my server and now I can show it to you. I go to my workflow activities. I already reactivated this document and now I complete it. And you see, finally, when I set the processed flag to true, then my document gets loaded and the methods to load the details and create effects are called. Yeah, and that is how you create a custom document and a workflow and model classes in IdemPierre. This is very, very basic. I'm personally still new to the whole document topic. And maybe I forgot something or did something wrong. And if you know it better, then please correct me. You can write me in the comment section below, or you can go to the wiki page and correct it there. And yeah, of course, you can come to IRC. I'm there Monday to Friday, 8 to 4 o'clock German time. You can send me an email. And I hope this video helps you. And we see us in the next video.